Hi again, people. Welcome back to this tutorial for beginners in AutoCAD. In this part, we will focus on the command array and in the tools at the utilities panel. Let's start. How to use array. With the command array, we can copy objects arranged in a pattern. There are three different modes: rectangular array, polar array, and path array. I start with rectangular array, and for that I just need to click on the button, that's the mode set by default. Then I'm going to select these objects and press enter. So an array was generated and a special tab on the ribbon has appeared. Now I can edit this pattern as I wish. Here I can set the number of columns and rows. If I decrease the number of columns, for example from 4 to 3, as you can see on the screen, the last column is suppressed. The array creation, I find it very intuitive. And I think it's easy to understand the options here, while looking to these little drawings there. The distance between is the distance from the origin to the beginning of the next element. The distance total is from the origin to where the last element starts. Simple. I'm going to change the distance between rows to 200. And look how the pattern moves. Of course, the total distance was updated in order to match to the new distance between lines. To exit the array mode, I press escape. Now, if I want to confirm the distances, I can use the measure tool or type DI and press enter. Notice that the vertical length between two elements matches, as well as the horizontal length. Grips in an array object. Whenever I select an array, you can see these dynamic grips, the blue buttons here, which I can use them to modify this array. For example, if I click on this one, on the second row, I can change the vertical distance between two objects. For that, I simply type the new length. To change the horizontal length, on the other hand, click on this one. If I click on the grip at the last row, I can add more, for example, 7. If I click on this side, it's the numbering of columns that I can change. The grip on the opposite corner changes both rows or columns by dragging the mouse. Basically, these operations can also be performed on the Array tab, but sometimes it's just more practical with these buttons. Another useful thing in Array is changing the base point. I click on this icon, set the new point, for example, or on the corner. And the grips moved with the base point, but they perform exactly the same actions. Let's make a polar array. I'm going to draw a small circle with its center located at the boundary of this big one, on this side. Now I can click on the command polar array. It's this one there. Basically, what I want is to have this object displayed around. I click on it, then the center point of array is going to be the center of the biggest circle. And that's the result. The program sets 6 circles around by default, but like for the rectangular array, I can edit this on the tab at the ribbon. So, the array tab for polar array is a bit different, especially the panel items. On the first parameter, I set the number of items. In this case, I specify 18, and they cover all the circumference, because I have 360 degrees for the fill parameter. In between, I specify the angle between two items, and in this case, it's 20 degrees. If I try to change the angle to 30, you can notice that it doesn't work, because it's not possible to fit 18 items with that spacement. Let's try 15 degrees. So what happened here? In order to keep 18 items, the angle on fill was updated. Now it's only 255. Grips on polar array and tips. The small square on the original item allows me to change the radius of the array. I'm going to set, for example, 50. And this is how it looks like. The grip on the center can be used to change the position of the array. On the other hand, if I click on this little arrow, I change the angle between two items. Let's suppose I want 6 items. The angle to have them distributed equally is 60 degrees. However, it's possible to increase a bit that angle, but the last and first item will stay closer than the others. Path array. The third array mode available in AutoCAD is path array. We can copy objects along a line or a curve. Let's see how it is. First, I'm going to draw a spline, which is a smooth curve. I click on the command located here, Spline Fit, and I can draw a curve by specifying some points. On Spline Fit, the curve crosses exactly the points that I insert. When I finish, I press Enter. Here, by pressing Escape instead, it cancels the command. It will not work. Next, I draw a rectangle on the first endpoint of the spline. Now let's use the path array. I click on the icon. Select the object to copy. Press Enter. And then, I select my path. So, I have made it. However, probably I want to edit the spacement, position or rotation. At the command bar, you can easily check out that there are several options to edit. Let's analyze some of them. Base point. The base point will be exactly at the start of the path. I click on the option, then I change, for example, the base point to the opposite corner. And that is the result. The object moved, but without rotating. Tangent direction. This one is useful if I want, for example, to have one of the rectangle edges tangent with the curve. I'm going to click on the button Tangent Direction, then just specify two points, and the objects will rotate. But now suppose that I want a path to cross the center of the objects. I'm going to use the option Base Point and click on the center of the rectangles. It's not snapping to the center point. If this happens to you, it means that you should turn on the mode Geometrical Center in Object Snap. It's this one. Now it's going to appear. I just need to hove the boundary first and click on the center. Array tab on the ribbon. The tab on the ribbon is now specific for path arrays, especially the first panel. I can change here easily the spacing between, total spacing and number of items. I think the best way to absorb these things is to simply practice. You can play around with all these options and after a while, it will be easier for you. explode objects. Once I create an array, all the group is considered a single object. Now imagine that I want to get rid of the array. It doesn't work with just select it and press delete. It too erases the whole thing as you see. What I need is the command explode. It basically returns a compound object to its original components. It's very easy to use this. I click on the command explode, select the array and press enter. As you see, all these are now separate polylines. Then I can manipulate the objects as my preference. Consequently, I can explode the polyline in separate lines. Another way to use explode is on blocks. Hatches and other kind of objects. But some of them, it doesn't work like text. Utilities panel. Let's talk about the utilities panel, and I'm going to start with the measure tool. There are several ways of measuring, as you can see here. I start showing you the first one, quick measure, which is the one set by default when you click on this button for the first time. When I move the mouse over the objects, some dimensions appear on the screen, and these yellow lines measure vertical and horizontal distances between the closer objects. On the other hand, if I try to check the dimensions in a circle, at the first time it looks a bit confusing, all these values here. But they just show the radius of the circle they indicate. For example, 100 is the radius of the biggest circle, as well as 15 is the radius of the small circle. The yellow lines don't measure anything here, just don't care about them. Honestly, this quick measure, it's not my favorite, because even it's true that we can have a lot of information at the same time, it can be a bit confusing. But of course, that is just a personal taste. The icon distance, I use it a lot, as I find it very intuitive. It simply measures the linear distance between two points. Another one which is very easy to use is radius. I only need to click on a circle to check it out. Measure an angle. This one is simple. I can select two lines to measure the angle between them. Or I can check out the angle of an arc by clicking on it. Now let's go to where I was before. I want to focus on something. When I select the objects to measure the angle, this menu appears where I can choose from different types of measures. I'm going to click on, for example, area, and with this I can measure the area of the triangle. It's very simple, I just need to click on all the vertices and press enter at the end. Then you can see in this box the area and the perimeter. But how could I measure the area of a circle since it doesn't have corners? I click on the icon. Then, at the command bar, I can switch to object. I type O and press enter. Finally, I just select the circle. Quick select. On the utilities panel, you can find other tools at the small icons at the right. The first one above is quick select. If I click there, I open this window where I can select objects by using filters. For example, I can specify a type of object or select by color. Now, I will select all the objects with color cyan. Click on OK, and here it is. This is the only one in this color. Other options can be select all the objects of a specific layer, or you can select by line type, among other options. If I click on this icon, I select all the objects in the workspace, except the ones that are frozen or unlocked layers. The button below is the quick calculator. Actually, it's a kind of scientific calculator, and there we can do from basic calculations to a bit more complex ones. Okay, thank you very much for watching this tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe to CAD in Black if you haven't done it yet. Just click in the icon that is shown here. Also, if you need online private lessons, you can send me an email to the address that I show you there. So, it's everything, and see you next time!